ride, so it's much cooler now to walk through the streets, and probably less crowded now since I think the last train ride just left for the day. So let's go and find out what this beautiful town known as the Switzerland of Pennsylvania. So I'm going to start. Yeah, much earlier when I was here waiting for my train ride, this place was jam-packed. And it's not that it isn't anymore. I mean, it just probably doesn't have the now the traffic as much as when the train ride was were happening a little bit ago. So like I said, the last train just left for the day. Ah, you got me. The plant man. I was so... I didn't super jump like some of these women do and stuff like that, but he did get me, so... Because I wasn't paying attention, and that's what he really wants, to make sure that you're not really paying attention, so... So now I'm just walking down Broadway here, checking out this quaint little town. Great. So there's the Dimmock Memorial Library. I think I'm gonna have to get pictures of a lot of this. I don't know how I'm gonna do this both. I may have to. The more beautiful buildings are on that side of the street as well. But maybe I can get them right off the video as well. Just gonna enjoy the yeah, this is walking up West Broadway here. Such beautiful architecture, the Victorian architecture that's here. And pretty much this is the more touristy spot as well. So over here, this earlier when we passed by, there was no parking here. Now the parking is opened up because most of the, like I said, the train-related events and train rides are done, so. And there are a few little side streets as well. I'm sure you've seen this tour from many other people as well, but this is my point of view of it as well. It's a beautiful town though. Everybody always wants to say hi in a certain way.
Yeah,
cool. And again, the beautiful Victorian architecture is amazing. So there's one of the side streets that go down back to the main street down that way. We'll explore that out right before we leave, but there's the Mauch Chunk Opera House. They do have performances all the time there, as you can say, because Jeffrey Gaines, Adrenalize are going to be there, I guess, next weekend. The Marion Hose Company, I believe. That was a fire station at one time, I believe. There's the First Presbyterian Church. It's open.
Are you a YouTuber?
Mm-hmm. So like I said, this is the later part of the day now, so the throngs of tourists have pretty much dissipated as much. There's the ballroom. Oh, the Mauch Chunk Museum is here, okay. What time is, I wonder what's it open till. So here's the Mauch Chunk Museum, and it's housed, it looks like an old church at one time. I was hoping to bring you guys more videos, but I've already kind of exhausted myself today. To a degree. And I think there's not much more touristy anymore at this end. I know it usually goes for about 3 blocks, they said. So I think I'm gonna... Alright, that's my t-shirt that I bought at the train station. The bag it's in, it's ruffling. Now, I thought they said that the... there was the old jail was up this way from what I had seen on other videos. But again, they have a few quaint Victorian era homes, and I still would like to get up to the both Packer homes as well before calling it a day and heading home. house. Oh, there it is. So I would have sold myself short if I had not made it up here, up to the old jail. If you didn't know, this is the, I believe this is the jail that the Molly Maguires were held at. I'm not sure if this, I believe this is the one that supposedly had the handprints of a basically condemned man. But there was an innocent man. And they said no matter what they try to do, it won't go away. So unfortunately I probably just missed the last tour of the day. Yeah, I did. The time I made it up here. So there's the old jail. Yep. There's the information about the Molly Maguire's execution. So they were executed here at this old prison. There's a beautiful church up that way. And I know there's another church that other people have walked down to, but so this was the old Carbon County Prison. Erected in 1869 and 70. So they started in 1869 and completed in 1870. Yeah, you pretty much have to pedal up this hill because even if you kick in the motor on that electric e-bike, the throttle, shall I say, you still have to do some pedaling up because it's a little bit steep. So I think I'm just going to go up to this church, head back the other way, and then hopefully get up to the Packer Mansion. Sorry for the music. I'm trying to drown it out, but it was, I think, drowning me more out. So, Immaculate Conception Church sells their parking space here. On this side over here, I don't know if they do it for the main church at all. But that's one beautiful church. And like I said, it's kind of good to have the town to yourself now, sort of, as the other visitors start to head home too, like myself. Beautiful church. Oh wow, that is neat. Oh, this must be the veterans. Yep. It's the veteran, Vietnam Veterans Memorial here in Mauch Chunk, Jim Thorpe. Oh wow, that is cool. Wasn't rushing so much, and if you could hear me over the water, that would be a cool hike up this creek. I don't know if this is the one that JP Videos had done. I don't think it was, but it looks similar. Oh wow. There's another beautiful Victorian house right up there. My wild Irish rose. I had thought about just doing a driving tour as well, but this looks a little better. To me, at least it does. Alrighty, I think we're good here at this next corner and head back down. Actually, I might even just head back down now. Hello. Sorry for that again. I can't control what people play or... So I'm just gonna cross over here. I was gonna go up to the top of the hill, but I don't think there's, as far as I know, much. That's interesting. Statue of Jesus Christ right there. I know I had heard something about some stairs that take you up to the near where the cemetery is at that way, that there was a debate about who owned the actual stairways when it came to maintenance and repair and cleaning during the winter months. So again, here's the Veterans Memorial. That was neat to see that. Not sure exactly where those stairs are. There's another former fire station, Phoenix Hose Company number 2. I think the other one we saw was down there. We're gonna pass by it. wish they had had this shirt in another color option, but they didn't when I bought it. Especially on a sunny day like this where the sun is now beating on my back. There looks like to be some kind of a ruin right here on this wall right here. Oh wow, yeah, you can see maybe a home or something, but you can see that there's a ruin right here. Has a little window right there. Sign on June 21st, 1877, four Molly Maguires, an alleged secret society of Irish mine workers, were hanged here. Pinkerton detective James Parlin's testimony led to the convictions for violent crimes against the coal industry. Yet the facts of the labor class and ethnic conflicts, even the existence of organization, remain contested. Six others were hanged on this day at the county jail at Pottsville. Okay. 10 more were executed in PA through 1879. So I wasn't sure it was here or at Pottsville, but I heard also about that. Four were here and six others were at Pottsville. So no tours on Wednesday. So there's the, they have an auto tour. I didn't realize that. Cool. So they also have an auto tour, and there's, I think it's not stop number one. So I don't know if you have to go online and find that. And it'll give you directions to the all the stops on the auto tour. I'm gonna have to try to talk over. I hear some music being played behind me in a vehicle or some sort. So I hope we didn't catch too much of it, so that I won't get flagged. We know how strict YouTube can be about that. But I know how to remove stuff anyway and replace it with other music if I have to. Hey, there's the same kid that was coming up the hill just a bit ago. Hello. The art shop and gallery right here. There's another set of stairs that go up on that wall right there as well. That's neat. Someone has borrowed an umbrella. Just remember to bring it back. If you happen to get caught here on a rainy day. which I thought that's how my day was going to be when I first started. Cool. And another whole bunch of beautiful Victorian homes here. Yeah, I'm not big on, I'm sorry, giving you a lot of the history of the towns, and well, unless I know it, something about it. Right off the top of my head, I can't remember when it was founded. I'm sure I should look at one of those street flags and it'll tell me. And I've seen other videos been done here during other parts of the year, like around Halloween and Christmas-ish. So sorry about music. Someone was playing music in their home and they have their window open, so I hope you didn't catch too much of it. That's a cool, it's not. So it's known as the East Fair House, or Das Fair House, or Das Bear House. It's a B, actually. Das Bear House. So is it the Beer House? That's cool. There's some stairs that are going up that way, but they're blocked off. I'm not sure if those were the one they were talking. No, this goes up higher toward the towards up that way, up behind it. They're up there somewhere. There's a set of staircase that were contested by the by who owned it. So now it's officially closed. Now the gentleman that was looking out the window, probably if anybody was planning to come in, and I didn't realize there was something there, a turbine of some sort right there at the ballroom, and it has information about it. I know people like hearing you talk about the history of a town as much as possible, but I like to include it in my description, and you can gather as much information there. And I usually post links to where the source is, or multiple sources. Again, here's the church, the First Presbyterian Church, with their lobster on the Shapolsky. Oh, it's a museum. I mean, an art museum now. It's not a church anymore. Cool. So it's a $5 admission in there. So I'm not gonna do that. And not because of the money. Wheel for the fire hose apparatus. Again, this was the old Marion Hose Company, number one. So Dimmock Memorial Library is hosting a historic home tours on September 17th. So if you want to check it out, come and scan the QR code if I can get it there. So I'm assuming they're opening the homes, or just have someone stop at each of the homes and give more information about that particular home. Now here, this is where my lies. I came down this way earlier, so I know exactly where that goes. That goes up the hill up there that I was talking about, that there's a set of stairways. There's a set of stairways that go up to the top up there. So I think I'm gonna, I don't know how I'm gonna do this. I should have gone up and came around the other way when I was doing that. We'll go down the alley over here really fast. There's an Airbnb, Dolan. I can imagine the beautiful views of this home. Cool, so there's Horizons. Lots of little shops along here as well. Cool. Somebody just made that with two pieces. They took the frame and whatever, the shield and stuff like that, and made a backdrop out of it. Oh, more of the shops are down this way. So I'll be returning back to the other side of the street after I get down to the bottom here. Wow, cool. You got some old classic cars here. Beautiful. Super Deluxe. Ford Super Deluxe. Chrysler. 40s, I would imagine. Trying to see what it says. Oh, New Yorker. Okay. So there's a Chrysler New Yorker. And again, I'm going to have to take a lot of these photos off of this video. It's interesting how they have all these walls, retaining walls, like terraces almost. Terraced areas. So this is Walbert's Hotel. Oh, cool. I saw another sign like that pointing to something else. So this is a stop sign here because this is a regular street. There's Mauch Chunk Coffee Company, which closed already for the day. Pretty much after a certain time, most of the businesses start shutting down, or I guess early. Bee Stung, Unique Gifts. Curiosities, Coffee and Ice House. So Douglas House. So, just to give you an idea, we started right up here at the train station, walked up, I'm walking up that way, coming here, I'm walking now right down this way, down Ray Street, probably going to have to head back up Broadway, go down, check out Trap Alley as well, and then head back down into the clock tower. Wow, look at that. They have bolts on the wall just to hold it back. Beautiful houses. Yeah, I'm walking on the street because there's very little traffic coming through here. Yeah, I know this is also going to be a very, very long video probably, showing you the town. like I said, a lot of the shops are now closed. I wanted to come here earlier, but I know there was a lot of foot traffic coming through, you know, showing that foot traffic coming through. Walking. I know there's a sidewalk there, but I want to feature some of the architecture here as well, which probably has been on every other video that you've probably seen. Everything nice gift shop. Come in, we're awesome. Oh, they're closed though. Like I said, a lot of these smaller shops close after they know the tourists are gone. There's a Time House Bed and Breakfast. And then there's this cool church here. Let me get back on the sidewalk because there's a vehicle coming. So there's the Tolman House. It's church parking only, reserved for the pastor. Which is, I believe, the church. This is St. Mark's and St. John's Episcopal Church behind me. Awesome. I like that. So this is, I know this is going to sound like sacrilege, but the 11th commandment. Beautiful. So if you look up there, it says, in memory of Asa Packer, erected by his wife. So his wife, Sarah, basically paid for this church to be built. And I'm not sure if they attended here. Like I said, I'll have to look up and let you know more of the history of this. Oh boy. So I believe this is Lehigh Street now. We're heading back to. So there's a Christmas shop called Jingle Bells. I'm not going to go back all the way down to the center over there. I'm just going to cross over and head back up. Then we're going to explore the other little alley up on the way Race and Broadway are. But again, this is a beautiful, beautiful church. Glad this is only one-way traffic, but now you're gonna get the glare of the sun. Oh, wow. We have a blessing box here, so if you needed anything, take whatever you need, leave what you can, but above all, be blessed. And they have a box for prayer requests. They have a food pantry as well, run by this church. A lot of the tourists are still coming and exploring these. There's one of those little lending libraries, little free library. Oh. I'm just curious if people lives up. Oh, this is a private residence. Okay, some of them are actual residences, and some of them are shop, where the shopkeepers probably live. Kind of had to stop the video because these people were using language. Look, they're having a garage sale. Needs a lot of work though. Oh, cool. There's another one of those signs with the arrows. I think it's more to bring you interest to the shops. So they have a lot of reserved parking here as well. They got some beautiful those beautiful cars are there. And there's another one. They're painted by a specific person, it looks like. Somebody's playing. Huh? Oh, there's the Jim Thorpe. It's still open. One of the few small Ray Street. So there's the Dimmick House. And I believe there's another alley up this way that we can go check out as well. And then we'll head back down the sidewalk over there. So I think this is where the alley is at. Trying to figure out if that's the address or if that's when the building was built. Oh, never mind. There's nothing there, so that's just the name of that one alley I was talking about. But I guess we don't have to go down that way now. So we're back on Race Street. We just came from doing the historic Race Street. See if I can get a quick video of the sign here, so I can snatch a video off of it. And back across street. I'm sorry if I'm driving you guys nuts. Yeah. Darn it. We're gonna be able to cross. Even though there's no actual crossing this way. Most people go up and do a full loop. So I'm gonna cross now. I have the opportunity. So this is the Dimmick House. This Italianate Victorian townhouse was the home of U.S. Congressman Milo M. Dimmick and his family. His son Milton founded the Dimmick Memorial Library in Old Mauch Chunk in their memory. So I wasn't, oh, there's down the rabbit hole. No, the signs don't say the year this town was founded, but like I said, I'll post that in the description. Trap Alley. So I believe that was Trap Alley behind us. Awesome. Due to the price increase in ammo, do not expect a warning shot. This place is politically incorrect. Say America's one nation, and the country. Salute our flag. With thanks to our troop. If this offends you, leave. Redneck area. Due to the high cost, do not expect a warning shot. This is not a gun-free zone. Interesting. So there's another So all the alley would have brought you down to the back. I don't know if there was any shops back there or not. Didn't quite look like it, but I could be wrong. Had to shut it off a little bit while the last tour for the trolley was passing by. Oh, I see why he was playing that song. Because there's the YMCA, Young Men's Christian Association. So I guess they probably play that song as the trolley rolls by. There's another one of those cool signs again with the arrow. As it drives back, how? Somersault Vintage Letterpress Shop. Cool. Dimmick. So that date that I saw earlier on that brick was the actual year that home was built. Like this one, 18, it says the lower part is 1889 and the upper part was 100 years exactly later. Interesting. It is now closed, obviously. Pro bono publico. So free library, vintage stuff, Rainbow's End, candy shop, treasure shop. They're the House of Jerkies. Try to talk over some of the music. You can't hear it now, so I had to stop recording because the guy's playing copyrighted music. So right over there is the tree man. This is what he looks like when he's not wearing the tree outfit. Carbon County Courthouse. So this is the most famous, well, the second most famous building. That one is the first, the Coal and Navigation building right there, headquarters. And then this is the Carbon County Courthouse that we were listening to play some beautiful music. There's the Hotel Switzerland. And the, I guess it's like a veterans memorial here. World War II honor roll. And they have Civil War. Civil War monument to those that served here in Carbon County, I believe as well. And then we're finally heading up to go see the Asa and Harry Packer houses. Oh, I'm glad I'm only gonna go up once and then come down once. Oh, okay. And they were right side by side here. Yeah, they are closed. I waited too long to come and check the grounds and the actual house. I believe they actually offer tours, but I don't know if it's actually right now. Let me see. Oh, the actual hours. Oh, they close at 3:30. So last tour leaves at 3:30, and they are open weekends, April, May, and November, and daily from Memorial Day to Halloween night. So I'm sorry, should have came and done this maybe a little earlier. And I think this is the road I was talking about, that if you keep going up here, that's the Asa Mansion. And then this is the Harry Packer, Asa Packer Mansion that you saw there. And then there's the Harry, I believe, father and son. Similar architecture, but slightly different over here at the Harry Packer. Now, I think it was up here that I was talking about, that there's a set of stairways. You go up this road, but you can't park nowhere along that road that takes you down, but I don't know if it was down further up or not. So, and then there's Camera Park is right there. So again, there's the Harry Packer home. Beautiful to see the ivy all around it still. But it looks like they are maintaining it still. And again, I apologize for not making it up here earlier. I should have came up here while I was waiting for my train ride that you will see in a separate video. We can walk into the Camera Park here. Oh, this is owned by DCNR. Okay. And then there's the, I think that's the carriage house. Yeah. That looks like either the carriage house or the mother-in-law's house. One of them. I am, how you want to say, pretty beat right now from walking around so much today and checking out the sights as well as the hike over there at Lehigh Gorge State Park up to the overlook and stuff like that. So check out all those videos as I put them out in the future. Right now, I'm not going to say exactly when that'll be, because I already have my, well, at least maybe I can look over here. I don't think this is trespassing anymore, but this area is anyway. Normally they have that gate open, but we can look around a little bit. Yeah, Harry Packer. Oh, it's a bed and breakfast. So that area over there around the back side, I believe it says it's closed, or the actual mansion is closed. But beautiful. Looks like it needs a little bit of repair here and there. Hopefully they'll fix that. But here's a view of the Asa Packer. That one you can tell is very well maintained. The paint looks still, now I know it's not recent, but I know they did a lot of the painting and stuff like that during COVID when they couldn't open it up. So again, I apologize not being able to go in and check out the tours like I wanted to, but at least you get to see the buildings. And we're heading back down to the center of town again. There's the train station. I'm not sure if the last train has arrived yet. I'd imagine so, pretty close. It's already, what, 5:30? Yeah, so it should be either almost here or probably did arrive already. I didn't hear no train horns, so. See, normally this gate would be open for people to come in and check it out and walk up to the mansion. But I was here, at least, in the town. Sarah, this was built not too long ago, before you would have to go around and come up this steep hill. Then they built these stairways. Which is pretty much about the same thing anyway. So just to let you know, there's no smoking in this area. So there's Molly Maguires, Irish pub also, in the building that was the Hotel Switzerland. And I'm not sure if it's still functioning as a active hotel, but I see that it has air conditioning, so maybe it is. And like I said, this is what I enjoy about this time now, because there's hardly very few of us that are straggling. So I'm gonna head down to the parking lot. I think that's what they had today, the big day out. enjoyed this tour of Jim Thorpe here, and I found it to be very interesting. This place is amazing. It's, again, like I said, known as the Switzerland of Peel. And I'm going to try to bring you more information about this town in my description, like I mentioned before. So if you enjoyed this tour of Jim Thorpe, formerly Mauch Chunk, please give it a like and consider subscribing, liking, and commenting. And if you would like to support me through Cash App, it's Simply Up for Venturing in the Cash App to help me go farther and better places, not always touristy places as well. Beautiful places like this. I've been wanting to come up here for quite a while. So I hope you enjoyed it, and like I always say, go create your own adventure, and I'll see you at the next location.